the buffet at Blacktown's Workers' Sports Club, and the only thing on the menu now is a chemical fogging. The club closed after being told an infected couple ate Sunday lunch there this week and last.
We immediately enacted our plan, and as a result, we've shut down this venue, and it'll be shut for several days yet.
The buffet, they say, had new rules to be COVID safe.
You're welcome to have all the food you like, but it's served safely and conveniently to you.
Overnight, several Western Sydney ambulance stations were shut down too because vehicles and paramedics had been at the Mount Druitt Hospital where one of the new cases sought treatment on Saturday night. Concerningly, officials still haven't found a link to any existing clusters.
We believe we'll see more cases in the coming days and we need to flush those out.
The key is testing, but at the Rooty Hill drive-through clinic today, there was barely a vehicle in sight. At nearby Emerton, just a handful of swabs while we filmed.
Just as a precaution, we haven't been, to our knowledge, exposed or not.
That's in and out. It's really quick.
It's so critical that we raise those testing levels.
There were just under 15,000 tests yesterday, a huge drop on recent numbers and the recent Christmas spike. The last time they were this low was December 18.
Yesterday was not our finest moment in terms of getting numbers of people out for testing.
The couple linked to the hospital were among five new cases overnight, including one more linked to the Borrella BWS.
The other two new cases are a man and woman from here on the northern beaches. It's likely they'll be linked to the existing Avalon cluster, which now numbers more than 150. But a month on, contact tracers still don't know who patient zero is.
But we always get to the bottom of what we think happened, and I'm confident we'll get there.
Until then, there are new alerts for Warriewood Square, including Coles, Woolies and Aldi.
This virus hasn't given up causing us grief as yet.
Police investigating this outburst over a QR code at Kellyville Ridge McDonald's have now arrested a man. The 25-year-old from St Mary's will face court next month. And on mandatory masks and household gatherings, the Premier today dashed hopes of a restrictions reprieve this week.
That depends on the health advice, but unlikely given where we're at.
Now, if you wanted any further advice on whether people are following those pleas to get tested, you've just got to look at where we are right now. This is the five-doc drive-through testing clinic. In the past half hour or so, we have seen just three, now four cars and one motorbike come through here to get a swab. The staff, well, they are here. They're standing there ready to go to work to swab people, but right now, there's, apart from this one car, there's just no one for them to go to work on. In contrast to that, more than a week ago here, the lines were stretching right up Parramatta Road, around 100 metres or so. Today, well, nothing like that whatsoever. Fair to suggest that tomorrow, I don't think the testing numbers will be much better. And there is one other issue that's emerging today. The Premier revealed that some people in their conversations with contact tracers aren't telling the truth because they are worried that they may be stung or fined for doing the wrong thing and breaking those rules. She said when they are talking to contact tracers, they can have every confidence that they can tell the truth without repercussions. Q.
Important details. Dan Sutton, thank you.